There's also a high demand for deepening democracy, human rights, and regular elections. There's no doubt about that. I followed the debate with a lot of passion about whether China should interfere or not. I don't think China needs to interfere. China could continue with its own policy. Africa already has enough instruments on peace, on democracy and governance. What China needs to do is to support Africa in the implementation of its own homegrown, homemade instruments on peace, security and governance.
What kind of China do you expect us to become? Would you like to expect a China, more offensive China, aggressive, arrogant, easily resort to embargoes or sanctions or military means to conflicts here in Africa, or rather a moderate China, a respective China, a China who is doing business quietly here, China who's doing something tangible here, building bridges, roads, railways, infrastructures to support the continent. The main common interest for China and Africa is peace and development. To develop a kind of partnership with the African Union in peace and security, that does not mean that China will intentionally interfere with the conflicts here in Africa. But we mean that we will work together closely with the African Union, with the regional organizations, with the countries concerned, to have more financial inputs to support the capacity building of the African Union for peacekeeping.
All our states have a certain level of fragility. The level of fragility might differ from state to state. And this fragility is very much related to our poverty. Definitely, a value-creating China and a rent-collecting Africa cannot be long-term partners. This China-Africa cooperation can be a genuine South-South cooperation as far as only it focuses in converting our societies into value-creating societies. I feel that one of the recommendations of this conference should be to ask the Chinese government to support Chinese researchers seriously, to support Chinese institutions, research institutions seriously in terms of research funds, in terms of study visit funds, in terms of collaborations with African institutions.